So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you and welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and upcoming NABARD exam. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will find the PDF of this session. And also you can ask any doubt here. So let's talk about the very first question, which says Hackathon Manthan 2021 is a unique national initiative to identify innovative concepts and technology solutions for addressing the DASH. Which challenges this hackathon, which is named as Manthan 2021, has been launched? The question is this. So let's talk about this news, guys. So remember, it was launched by Ministry of Education. Ministry of Education launched it, but it was organized by BPRND, which is Bureau of Police Research and Development. And this Bureau of Police Research and Development works for the modernization of the police forces in the country. हमारे देश की जो पुलिस फोर्सेज हैं उनके काम को मॉडर्नाइज करने के लिए काम करता है. इट इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन न्यू दिल्ली एंड रिमेंबर इट वर्क्स अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ होम अफेयर्स. ठीक है. सो इट वाज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय बीपीआरएनडी इन कोऑर्डिनेशन विद द इनोवेशन सेल ऑफ द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड AICTE, ऑल इंडिया काउंसिल ऑफ टेक्निकल एजुकेशन. ओके, नाउ व्हाट इज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस हैकाथॉन? सो क्वेश्चन में ही हमें पता चल गया था, इट्स ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू आइडेंटिफाई innovative and technological solutions for addressing the security challenges which are being faced by our intelligence agencies. जो हमारे intelligence agencies द्वारा जो security challenges face किए जा रहे हैं उनको innovation और technology की मदद से खत्म करने के लिए this hackathon was organized by BPRND. And remember, the participants are expected to develop the digital solutions in the area of six themes for 20 different challenge statements. And of course, these themes and these challenge statements are not important for the exam. Also remember that this Manthan 2021 will take place in two phases. Phase one jo hoga wo iska hoga basically apna idea present karne ke liye. This phase one is for presenting the idea and phase two is for demonstrating the idea. Okay, and total prize worth rupees 40 lakh will be given to the winners. So that's all about this news. Isme isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. And now let's come back to the question. So here in this particular news, you have to remember the name of this hackathon Manthan 2021, because they can also ask you the name. What was the name of this hackathon which was organized for identifying the technological solutions regarding the security challenges which are being faced by the intelligence agencies? So in that case, the answer would be Manthan 2021. But here in this question, the correct answer will be, guys, option B, security challenges. Option B is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 2, which is again a very very easy question and a very very important question. Ye question aapke NABARD ke exam ke liye hi banaya, samajh lo. In which country the BRICS agricultural research platform has been set up? कौन से देश में ब्रिक्स का एग्रीकल्चरल रिसर्च प्लेटफॉर्म सेटअप हुआ है? द क्वेश्चन इज दिस. सो रिमेंबर गाइज, इट हैज बीन सेटअप इन इंडिया एंड द यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर. हु इज द मिनिस्टर? इट्स मिस्टर नरेंद्र सिंह तोमर. नरेंद्र सिंह तोमर लोकसभा कंस्टिट्यूएंसी इज मुरैना. ठीक है, मुरैना से आते हैं ये. सो द यूनियन मिनिस्टर ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर हैज अनाउंस्ड द सेटिंग अप ऑफ ब्रिक्स एग्रीकल्चरल रिसर्च प्लेटफॉर्म एंड the setting up of this platform was announced that they will set up. It was announced in the 11th meeting of BRICS agriculture ministers. Jo BRICS agriculture ministers ki 11th meeting hui thi, usi mein ye announce ho gaya tha under the theme BRICS partnership for strengthening agro biodiversity for food security and nutrition security. All right, and why it has been set up? So it has been set up for strengthening the cooperation in the field of agricultural research, technology and other allied sectors as well. All right, so and talking more about this, so it is a global platform for science led agriculture. Of course, as the name suggests, BRICS agriculture research platform. So it will be a platform for conducting research in the area of agriculture. All right, and it will help in addressing the global issues like world hunger, undernutrition, poverty, inequality by promoting sustainable agricultural development throughout the countries of BRICS. All right, and it will also sustainably increase the yields and farmers' income in the BRICS member nations. So, guys, the correct answer should be what? Option A, India. So, it has been set up in India as announced by the Union Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. And also remember that the that its setting up was announced in the 11th BRICS meeting of agricultural ministers. Okay. And moving ahead to question number 3. Question number 3 says, among the following, which is not one of the collaborative bodies for executing the project QSIM, which stands for Quantum Computer Simulator Toolkit? This is nothing but a toolkit for advancing research in the area of quantum computing. Okay, this is nothing more than that. And this is important because this is India's first. So the Ministry of Electronics and IT, and who is the minister? It's Minister Mr. Ashwini Vaishnav. Ashwini Vaishnav is the Minister of Electronics and IT, and he is also the Minister of Communication and Railways. So this ministry has launched India's first QSIM, Quantum Computer Simulator Toolkit, which I already told you is nothing but a toolkit to enable researchers and students to carry out the research in the quantum computing area. Now this is very technical thing, we do not have to go into details of this. Isme ek do cheeze hain basic si, wo pad lete hain bas, zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. This project, remember, it is being executed by IISc Bangalore, IIT Roorkee, CDSC and Ministry of Electronics and IT. These are the four collaborative agencies which are implementing this particular project, and it meant to be a vital tool of learning and understanding the practical aspects of programming with the help of quantum computing. So this line, is tarike ki line main isliye deta hu so that you can use these lines in your descriptive paper. All right, and now let's come back to the question. So here in this particular news, you have to remember the name of this project, QSIM. Okay, because in short they can also ask QSIM, the ministry which has launched it, Ministry of Electronics and IT, and who are the, which organizations or which ministries or which bodies are the collaborating agencies. So IISc Bangalore is there, IIT Roorkee is there, CDSC is there, Ministry of Electronics and IT of course is there, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting is not there. So option E is the correct answer, guys, to this question. And who is the Minister of Information and Broadcasting? Can you tell me that? Please write down in the comments the name of Minister of Information and Broadcasting. And moving ahead to question number 4, guys, which is the last question for today, and that's very, very important question because it is regarding the Mission Karmayogi. If you remember, Mission Karmayogi, I hope aap sabko yaad hoga, it was launched last year in the month of September 2020. So Mission Karmayogi is for the developing the capacities of institutions and of the civil servants. Theek hai, Mission Karmayogi launch hua tha, and this question is regarding Mission Karmayogi only. So the Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions, which is headed by Dr. Jitendra Singh, this is headed by Dr. Jitendra Singh, inaugurated the Karmayogi Digital Learning Facility. Karmayogi Digital Learning Facility. Question is, it is meant to upgrade the skills of, very easy question, but yes, very, very important question. So it is meant to upgrade the skills of central government officers and personnel, because Mission Karmayogi was launched to upgrade the skills to for capacity building of the civil servants only. All right, so let's talk about this. Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pension has launched this Karmayogi Digital Learning Facility. Where? They can also ask you where. So it has been established at the Institute of Secretariat Training and Management. Institute of the Secretariat Training and Management, which works under the Department of Personnel and Training. Ye DOPT ke under institute hai, ye kaam karta hai. And there, this, at this institute, this Karmayogi Digital Learning Facility has been launched. And of course, we all know Mission Karmayogi was launched last year in the month of September. And these are some basic things about Mission Karmayogi, like this is focused on individual and institutional capacity building. The tenure of the project is 5 years. Total 510 crore has been allocated to this project, to this mission, and around 46 lakh central government employees will be benefited through this particular mission, which is known as Mission Karmayogi. And very important thing, that a capacity building commission will be set up under this project Mission Karmayogi, which will ensure a uniform approach in managing and regulating the capacity building. And usse bhi zyada important, a public human resource council will be set up, which has been set up already, which is headed by the Prime Minister. Okay, this council is headed by the Prime Minister, and this council will approve the civil service capacity building plans under the Mission Karma Yogi. Okay, so this is about Mission Karma Yogi, and now let's come back to the question. So I already told you the answer, I guess. It is meant to upgrade the skills of central government officers and personnel. So option E, guys, here is the correct answer. And that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.